If you're still using Windows 7 and you have some issues getting Google Chrome or Mozilla Firefox installed on Windows 7, I'm going to show you two different browsers that you can use instead of Google Chrome and Firefox. So for example, if you try to install Chrome, you'll see that your device won't receive updates because Chrome isn't supported on Windows 7 anymore. And if you go to the Mozilla Firefox webpage, you'll also see that it's not supported on Windows 8.1 and below. Now, if you're looking for a Google Chrome replacement that's being updated, I suggest that you use Thorium, and you can get it from this webpage called thorium.rocks. And I'll leave all of the links that I use in this video in my written guide, and you can find a link to that in the description of this video. But once you get to this webpage, you can just scroll down, and then you can find the Windows 7 link. You can click on that. And then if you scroll down on this page, you'll see a whole bunch of useful utilities and even some updates that you can install for Windows 7 to get updates past 2019. But for the sake of this video, you can click on this Thorium releases for Windows 7 link here, which will take you to the GitHub page. And then if you scroll down on this list, you'll get to the releases here. Now you have a whole bunch of options here. Depending on how up to date your Windows 7 is, you'll either be using this AVX2 mini installer or the AVX mini installer. And if you can't get any one of them to work, I recommend going for the Windows XP 64-bit or Windows XP 32-bit version, depending on what version of Windows 7 you have installed. The version of Windows 7 that I'm running isn't up to date, so the AVX2 version won't work for me. So I'm just going to go for the normal AVX version. So I'll click on that. It's going to prompt me to run or save the file. I'll just click on save, and then it's going to download Thorium for Windows 7. You might get that security notification. You can just click on run, and then it's going to install and launch Thorium on your computer. Now, once you have it installed, you can click on sign in, and you can sign into your Google account, and it's going to sync all of the bookmarks and your data from your Google Chrome profile into the Thorium browser because it's based on Chromium. And I'm just going to skip sign in for now and just show you that if I visit a page like Gmail, for example, there are no errors telling me that my operating system isn't supported or that the browser isn't supported because it runs on the latest version of Chromium. So if you're looking for a replacement to Google Chrome, go ahead and use Thorium. But if you're looking for a replacement on Firefox, I recommend that you use the Florp browser, and you can do a Google search for Florp GitHub releases. So you can get to the GitHub releases page. Click on that, and then on this releases page, you can either choose the Windows 64-bit or 32-bit installer, depending on which version of Windows 7 you have installed. I've got 64-bit installed, so I'm going to click on the 64-bit installer. Once again, just click on save. Once it's finished, just click on run to start the installation. Click on next, leave it on standard, click on next, click on install, and then click on finish, which will also launch the Florp browser. And this is what it will look like. And once again, if we just go to Gmail and open that web page, it works perfectly fine with no errors telling us that the operating system or the browser that we're using isn't supported anymore. So if you're still on Windows 7, I recommend installing both of these browsers, and then you can try them out and see which one you like best. But I hope this guide's been useful. Please like the video, and I'll talk to you guys soon.